be showing you guys how to set up your bird's cage. Since we've been doing the cage review videos, I figured it would be a good idea for me to actually go over how I personally prefer to set up my cages and the sort of little tips and tricks that I've learned over the years to help utilize and maximize the space that you have in a cage. So we're gonna hop right on into it today and we're gonna set up the cages.
So the first thing we're gonna start off with is the perches. Now I have a lot of variety with my natural wood perches. I don't have any dowels, and that is because dowels are very smooth and they're very flat, which can cause a lot of sores for birds' feet. So the more depth and the more variety with textures and thicknesses, the better. So I've got my empty cage here and I'm gonna go ahead and start with the biggest and highest perch. Now I like to put the weirdest ones at the top because then you can hang toys off of them and have it have a lot more depth with where the toys actually fall in the cage. Birds tend to like to sleep nice and high in their cages, so I like to make sure there's at least one perch that's really close to the top so they can cuddle into a corner and feel nice and safe. The rest of the perches are just kind of random. You do want to make sure that your perches are going all the way down to the bottom though, because a lot of the time you'll only put perches in the top half of the cage, and you'll find that your bird doesn't want to go down to the bottom as much because it is lower and is a bit scarier. So you want to put your perches down lower as well as up high to encourage them to actually utilize the full space of their cage. The other thing you want to watch out for is that none of your perches are overlapping, because if your bird is standing on a perch and they poop and there's another perch right beneath it, they will end up pooping on the perch and it is very difficult to clean. Next up, we've got toys. Now what toys you use is entirely up to you. I like to provide as much variety as possible with my toys. Even if it's a texture my birds don't like at this moment, I still like to provide it because you never know if they're gonna have a weird mood one day where they just decide to try it out. So I like to give them as much different textures and colors and things as possible to encourage them to play and explore their cages a bit more. So we're gonna go ahead and start placing the toys in. How you put them in is really completely random again. I like to just make sure that there isn't anything cluttering up the center. Keep really big bulky toys to the sides, put some foraging toys down below because they're gonna go for the food, they're gonna want to go down there and explore a bit more and really utilize the space. I like to make sure that there's a big fluffy toy near where I think the birds are gonna sleep because then they can chew on it as they nap to help prevent plucking behaviors and overpreening. Everything else is kind of random. Don't forget that you don't have to hang everything off the walls and off the ceiling. You can hang things off of the perches, you can lay things on the floor, you can lay them across perches. There's all sorts of different things you can do than just hanging them off of the ceiling. So we've got a good amount of space in here. I have left some gaps on the walls because we still have to make room for their bowls. So we don't want to forget that we clutter things up too much. Again, with the toys, try and make sure that there isn't anything immediately beneath a perch that they're going to be sleeping on or spending a lot of time on. Otherwise, the toy's going to get covered in poop, and that's not going to go too well for you when you have to try and clean it off later. Lastly is the bowls. Of course, we have stainless steel for the water, and then I use plastic for their pellets. You can use stainless steel for their pellets. I just find these are easier to take on and off to clean every day. And then lastly, I've got a cuddle bone, which isn't necessary, but I just prefer using them. And I like to make sure that these are on opposite sides of the cages, as far away from one another as possible, and that the water is higher than the food. If the food is higher than the water, often birds will actually take their pellets and drop them in. If they're too close to one another, pellet dust or seed husks will fall into the water and contaminate it. So you want to make sure that these are on opposite sides of the cage at a relatively similar height, or water a little bit higher. Personally, I put water higher, but if they're on opposite ends of the cage, it doesn't really matter. I ended up moving some perches around after this because I realized that the perch closest to the water bowl was actually going to end up getting pooped on if Newt sat up and drank his water. So I just moved it back a little bit more to help alleviate some of those problems and had to move the perch beneath it over a little bit just to make sure nothing's going to get excessively dirty and be unsanitary for him. The last little detail I'm going to put in here is I'm going to take a bunch of Newt's foot toys, which are just tiny loose toy parts and things he can hold in his feet and crunch, and I'm just going to scatter them around the cage. I toss a few on the floor, I tuck some in on the perches, I hang some off of the branches. This gives him something to grab, something to throw around. Conures tend to like to make a lot of noise, so I like to give him things that he can throw and thrash and bang and have a bit more fun with. And that is pretty much it. So as you can see, we do have quite a few toys in here. We have quite a few different perches. We've got a lot of variety and depth in this cage without over-cluttering it. If I had taken really big things and slammed them in the middle or done all the perches off of the same walls, it ends up being really plain, it ends up being really flat, and it ends up taking a lot more space. By putting perches off the side walls as well as the front walls, I can't personally put them on the back walls because my cages are attached to the walls, but making sure that you're putting them off of every surface opens up that space a lot more, and making sure that your toys are against walls and not cluttering up the middle is a good way for your bird to make sure that they can fly in between each perch and get proper exercise without toys cluttering up the space. There's a lot of different things that you can do with your cage. I by no means have done all of them. You can always use swings, you can use hanging perches, you can use platforms. There's all sorts of different things you can do to create more depth in a cage and utilize the space. The main thing is just that you want them to have a lot of variety in their perches. You want them to be able to easily flap their wings when transporting themselves around the cage, and you don't want to overclutter things where your bird has difficulty moving around and spreading their wings. If they're going to be in your cage for any length of time, more than an hour, you want to make sure that they can fully flap and get the exercise that they need if they're going to be in the cage for extended periods of time. So the more space you can give them while still providing as many toys as possible is a very tricky balance to make, and it's going to be kind of a lot of trial and error of putting things in and having to move them around.
So that is it for today's video. I hope this helped give you guys some new ideas and things to think about when setting up your bird's cage. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye!